All right, ladies and gents, and welcome back. Let's close that. To the Etheri Covenant. And last time we left off, I think we established our first colony, and indeed we are establishing our first colony, and we're building a second colony ship, which I presume I was going to put here in Revac. So Revac Prime can be born anew. We also have built ourselves an observatory monitoring a primitive species. So that's nice. And that's it. That's all we really have done so far. Oh no, we've got a spot here. 20. Yes, that is probably what I was going for. Sod you. And you're 17. Going for the 20, man. Considering our science ship is already here scouting this system out, I assume that's where we were going. So, a word of note is when the autosave pops up every now and then, it may take a little longer to save than it normally would. This is because obviously the game saves to cloud simultaneously as it saves to your computer, but I'm also uploading a video at the same time, so just be aware of that. And be patient. Oh no, it wasn't too bad, the autosaves. That's fine by me. So why is draining our influence then? We're only getting two influence. Let's have a look. Base is free, frontier outpost, right. Yes, I probably built that so I can maintain the observation post, didn't I? Did I build it? Yeah, it'd be here. Okay, well that is fair enough. We've got a lot of anomalies to look for, haven't we? Jeez, I'm going to have to read those at some point soon. Yes, I do remember now. Yeah, we went for a good exploration trip down here. Our science ship is still cleaning up the undiscovered mess. And then we're going to make ourselves a new home. In Trigen? I can't really read it when it's grayed out like that. So, as soon as we finish surveying the system, we'll know. We will know. I'm actually curious whether I actually set any of the anomalies to research. It doesn't look like I did. I know what I would have done, yeah. As soon as I finished all this, we'll go back, we'll look at the anomalies. That would have been the sensible me thing to do. Ah, it's Fijian. Fiigan, by the looks of it. So we're going to have a planet called Fijian Prime shortly. Hooray. Speaking of which, is that a colony ship? Anyone here done? No, not particularly, no.
System survey complete.
There we go. So Fijian is completely surveyed. And we have a new planet, which we are going to colonize as soon as possible. A nice alpine world, just like our own, with 20 slots. Which is better than our own, but some of those slots are going to be uninhabitable, I assume. Yeah, we got quite... Have we? Not at all. Me likey the alpine world. We haven't... From what I can tell, we haven't got any that are uninhabitable. That is fairly amazing. Uh-huh. I thought we had a resource then, but we don't. Well, speaking of which, let's have a look at our resources research. So we've got just under 2 years until we get the symbol of unity building. That's nice. 36 months until we get a new fusion reactor. That's a while. And we've got 30 months until we get the cargo, which again. It is a while. So research at this point in time is a slow, drooling process. So, yeah, bit of patience and we'll be Rita's reign. So while we wait for our colony ship, which is nearly done actually, let's have a look at the... Just remind ourselves... Thank you. Just remind ourselves of the planet that we are observing. Yeah, we got these fugly looking things. I think they were in a Bronze Age, were they not? If I was yeah, a Bronze Age. Okay. So they're probably creating their version of the Roman Empire at the minute. Or Alexander, the alien thing. Okay, what are we waiting for? Colony ship, come on. We got fusion to colonize. Fusion! The beautiful world that is on Fusion Prime. There we go. That sound is always equal parts comforting and irritating at the same time. What resources are on Fusion? Ah, we're going to knock out the two minerals, but that's not a problem. We're going to colonize Fusion 3. I'm calling it Fusion. Somebody's probably going to rage at me for calling it Fusion. It looks like that's how it's pronounced. So for 30 influence we can colonize a place and where's a plant? I could get extra food there. That is actually perfect. Absolutely perfect. Right there. We could get a bonus to food, bonus to energy, bonus to minerals, and I'm not sure if I get two bonus to minerals, but there's always a chance, so ba bam. Yep, Fusion Prime. Is it on? Oh, it's Fusion. Fusion. Seems Frenchy slash Chinese at the same time. Very weird. So we're losing. Oh, that arrived suddenly.
Construction complete.
That's what she said. Yeah, so we're losing credit slowly. Construction complete. Are you a bit late? Because. Space bar is. Did I build another. Oh, I must have, yeah, I've got 8 now, okay. Must have ordered another corvette to be constructed after that. So once again, our colony ship is now all the way over here. Oh my god, he's a busy boy. And why is there a red marking next to this planet? Is there hostiles here? We surveyed it, so it can't really be. Unless they arrived just as we left. I am curious. Let's go have a look. Ah, there's another planet we could possibly colonize down here. Arctic world, though, we have a 60% habitability, but we could get rid of our frontier outpost here, which could be useful. Give us that extra point in influence back as we begin our colonization process of fusion. Fusion? I'm going to be arguing with that pronunciation for a long time. Whatever. Okay, so there's nothing hostile here. There is something hostile here. Come on, go back, go to it. There is. It's the pirate station, I believe. It is. All that searching around, it was right under our noses. Go kick its ass, shall we? Nice point of view from right behind our fleet.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Oh nice, yeah, they broke off then, that was cool. not getting any return. Oh yeah, we are getting return fire. Oh crap. Ugh. One ship. Oh no, we might not. It's close. I think we got it. We've got it. The First Navy cluster has destroyed the pirate station in the Tangilian system. And recovered the strong room module. Sweet! Which gives us plus 80 mineral and plus 50 energy credits.
Situation log updated.
Which is not too bad. Let's just add that to our list of things our science ship has to do and you guys go for a repair. Is that sad on? No. There we go. Yeah, a couple of little glitchy moments there. Right, so we've defeated the pirates completely now. Their base is no more. We have a lot of things to do before we get to that research. I might prioritize that first. Let's have a lot of going yeah, I think I will. Right. Let's go here. Let's research that. Do that first, and then we'll go back up to here. Survey the remainder of that system. We then went down here, didn't we? Survey this system. Survey this system and then survey that system, and I think at that point we can return back to Rontus. Sure, the knowledge that we have protected our people once more. Kind of a funky pattern that, isn't it? And then we can look to these anomalies that we've got dotted around. We've got a level 1 here, level 2 on there. Yeah, we've got quite a few. Level 1 there as well. So there's a bit we could be doing, and we will do, obviously. While we wait, we may as well build up our resources and research gains. Oh, we've already built them there. Over here, are we building you? No, we have not, but can we not? Are you not in our controlled space? Yeah, it's not in our controlled space. What about you? That is. And I assume I built the. Yeah, I built the research outpost there. Are you in our space? Yeah. Mining station, nice. That's quite a lot of minerals to add there, and if I can get the right click on proper, another research station, that'd be nice. Power may start running low. I think we've built all these, haven't we? No, we have not. 202 for another Cool. 202 for another 8 mineral income. Nice. There's a lot of minerals around here, which is fantastic, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to be a bit on the cautious side because of energy credit income. Auto saving again. Let's see, our science ship's still there. It looks like they're working on the rubble. Picking it apart and seeing what's what. That's another one actually we could do with we have done them with we haven't got enough minerals to do much now, so it's time we better spent saving.
Colony established.
Yay, there we go, we're back in the positive for energy credits.
Debris analysed.
Swish, what did we get? Active countermeasures, nice, plus 10%. Nano composite materials, plus 10%. Physics research, plus 10 points. And engineering research, plus 15. That is quite nice. Let's give us a nice boost. This is going to take a year now till we get Calguns, which is a nice boost. 7 months until we get that, and 15 months until we've finally got our new reactors up and running. So we're getting there, we've got a nice boost coming on. Let's have a look at our planet states. See, we've only got one governor. I'm very loath to put multiple governors in these positions. I'd rather have one governor and swap him out. 12, 13. I'm looking for... Is it giving us plus 2? They've got enough food, they've got enough... As long as they've got food and they're generating positive income on their energy credits and materials, I'm happy enough to leave them be as they are until they get the unemployment stat on them or whatever. So he's back up here, continuing now surveying these systems. Revac. What's the 17, 55%? It's not worth doing that. I think for now we'll just look for Alpine Worlds and look to these other planets later on when we get a bit more adaptability going on. So really we're just letting our resources build, our science ship complete its rounds. I always zoom in like too far, don't I? I was like, rrr. Just kind of want to see where he's going. Oh, that is a big gas giant. It is a gas giant, isn't it? It is, hurry. Look at the size of it.
Construction complete.
So our construction ship going out there, getting us more resources. Nice, 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 nice. Let's see where he's at. He's over there. So we could really do with finding more energy at the minute, but I think I'm going to rely on my planets for that more than anything. Speaking of which, it would be wise of me to start building proper structures. To assist with these things. So we can get a bit better research. Can we upgrade that? We can upgrade that. 90. What's it upgrade to? We've got a power plant too already. We'll go for that. Can we afford to upgrade? No, we cannot. And this is assuming this is a planet with a governor, right? Yeah. What does he actually give us? Construction time.
Research complete.
Clear block time. He doesn't actually give us anything great, does he? Happiness plus 4%. Yeah, he doesn't actually give us much in the way of buffs. So we now got this symbol unity building. Let's see. We can get terraforming.
System survey complete.
I think we'll go for propaganda broadcasts. Terraforming is a bit ahead of us yet, so we're not too worried about that. It could be useful to start early on. I don't know. There's positives and negatives to every scenario in this game. It is technology where your most problems lie. We need to, once I start doing the anomalies, I think it's time after that to think about exploring again, pushing further out. I don't want to be boxed in at any point. I mean, we are in quite a nice spot to, hopefully we're not boxed in. Only 10 empires are in this, and a mass of stars, we should be okay. What's this over here? Oh right, it's one of the nebulas. The Temestra Badlands. Seems like some out of Borderlands, doesn't it? The Badlands. So after we search these stars down here, that's it. That's the end
construction
of
construction complete.
Our space. So we're getting plus 20, nice. We're getting plus 20 minerals now, and plus 11 energy. So we're doing good. So we're now surveying this system here. Our construction ship is building in this system. We've got another two minerals to get out of there, and two something about society research, which is quite frankly our best research at the minute, our fastest developing one at least. So we should have this in, I was going to say no time.
Anomaly found.
Okay, we'll just add that to the stockpile, I suppose. 9 months until this is finished, until we get Calguns, which is fantastic. And as well, 9 months till we get new reactors. Sweet. That's kind of convenient. We may need them to power our new weapons. Wow. Sorry, I was kind of looked 1 minute. We had 99 resources, and then we have 140 next time I check. Let's have a look to upgrading some more things. Can we upgrade these? No, just our... there's no one on there yet, so we don't have to think about upgrading that. Somebody on there though. Is it worth upgrading it now? Yeah, yes it is. No, it is not. We can't afford it. Give it another couple of days, and another 10 days, we'll have 90, we can establish that. There we go, so we can now build that. We've got a slot here that's only given us 2, so I'm assuming that's not been built at all. How much would it cost us to build? Per plant, basic 60.
Construction complete.
So 3 months worth, basically. We'll hold off on that. We'll let the buildings we've got going finish, I think. That should give us plenty of power for now. So let's have a look at this list. So our capital planet is giving us plus 14 energy credits, plus 30 minerals. We could do with upgrading these, to be honest. That's giving us plus of neither, but we're getting positive food. That's good, that's good, that's good. Yeah. So slowly but surely we're getting there. There you are. Yeah, this guy's got a lot of work to do. I said once he's surveyed them two, that's it, he's on his way back home, but he'll soon be sent back out again to discover all these anomalies, which will hopefully give more resources for our construction crew to take advantage of, which is really what we're doing nicely. Not really much to
system survey complete.
Oh, here we go. What is this? The Etheri civilization encountered this time. We have detected the presence of an alien civilization on Avik. Avik Zajax. Zajax. I just call it Avik Zajax. In the Skeptrum system. They appear to be in the early space age. That's nice. As evident by the many primitive satellites orbiting the homeworld. The nation states are on the path toward joining together in a global government, and it is likely only a matter of time before they venture beyond their world and join the galactic community. We should consider building an observation. Oh, hell yeah, we're building an observation post. Where was that? Survey completed. For our survey of habitable worlds. Oh, right, okay, nice. Our survey of habitable worlds. Our biologists have collected a vast amount of data on alien life forms. Many of our older theories on development of life have been disproved, and our scientific community has had to build a new model from scratch. Our most interesting findings are being displayed of the newly dedicated Museum of Exobiology on Rontus Prime. The public is enthralled, and many donations have come in to aid in the continuation of strange life forms. My god, I don't know why I kept saying continuation. So we get a nice bunch of society research and energy credits. That is nice indeed. Okay, so it must be this system. Is this system within our reach? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. So, here, we're going to build an observation post. Now, this observation post is going to come in much more handy. So, look, what's a culture called? The Etheri civilization. So if we go here and have a look. Yeah, there we go. Etheri, let's see. The militarist, fanatic spiritualist, but the militarist. So they're kind of like a crusading state, if you will. I think they'll get along with us just fine. We're both spiritualists. They're fanatics, but they're also militarists. We're not peaceful, so we don't clash with them on that. We're the same as them on this, of a little bit lighter on the spiritual side of things.
Construction complete.
I think we can infiltrate them. I think we can bring them into our empire. And I think that'll be something interesting to do. It's one of my favourite mechanics about this game. You can enlighten them and they can become independent, or you can infiltrate them and bring them into your society, which is fun. Plus, what type of planet do they like to inhabit? A desert world. That is handy. So if we come across any desert worlds, these are the guys to take. Yeah, infiltrating does take a long time, though. I will say that. And can potentially take a lot of resources. So we're going to have to be a bit careful on that end, but...
Research complete.
I think we should be fine and dandy with it. Alright, nice. So we got both our reactors and our new weapons. So we can have this research, gravity sensors, capacity overload, power hub. I kind of do want a power hub. Sentinel point defense.
Anomaly found.
Oh my god, another. Jeez. Level 1. Again, we're going to do them all one after the other. So leave it alone for now. We'll go for the gravity sensors. Here. Defense platforms. No. Storage capacity. Mining network 2. Very tempting. Yeah. Oh, we could get armor though. We're already partway there for the armor. Yeah, no. Mining network 2. We've got the armor. We can do that anytime. So get the mining network, get more minerals, and then we can go for the armor after that. Is the hope. Unless something else more tempting pops up. So what was I seeing now? That was it. I was going to see if I can build mining stations here. Need another 180 to build all the research stations. Two of them even. So our constructions are, I think, are nearly complete on our home planet. Have a look here. Oh yeah, the last one. So eventually it'll be time for our governor there to move on to our next colony. And hopefully these guys here will become part of that sooner rather than later. What are they called again? Yeah. The Etheri civilization. Hopefully the Etheri will become part of the Etheri covenant. And we can...
Construction complete.
Work with them as soon as possible. Would be my preference. My preference doesn't always go the way I want it to, though. Also, I'm thinking, here's another thought. As soon as we get that planet inside, we might not need that frontier outpost, which would be very nice indeed. So this frontier outpost can piss off eventually, which will give us a extra bit of influence every month. God, I've been talking too much and my throat is gone hoarse. Well, we've passed the half an hour mark, so I'll go a little bit longer. Again, the beginning of the game is a rather slow-paced affair.
Construction complete.
So it's going to be a lot of this waiting around, just watching things unfold and building up our resources and so on and so forth. We're getting a nice chunk of resource. We're almost at 30 minerals per month and 14 energy credits, which is very nice indeed. Yep, I think in a couple more months we'll have that 180 to build the research stations down here. And I think I'll call that enough for now for our... oh my good grief, look at that. Nine minerals, and he's not even finishing surveying the system yet. That is touching. That is nice. There's also some energy credits I could get here as well. I think after I've built these, I'm going to stop for the construction.
System survey complete.
11. Oh my god, that is awesome. Yeah. So after I've done this, once I get 5 planets as well, I'm going to just go on a big construction binge within my system. Of all the systems that I can build stuff in, I'm just build. And then from then on, it's up to sectors then. Because I'm going to start establishing sectors after I reach five planets, and sectors are automatically controlled, determined by some rules that you set for them. Because you can only handle five planets, or five systems, should I say, at once. We've currently got three. So once that occurs, we can afford the thingy. I'm going to do the basics for them. I might build a couple of mines so they can get the basic materials and then work their way up from there.
But research complete.
The ideal situation is I don't have to tax them until like an emergency
construction
situation.
Complete.
So I want them to build up to the maximum amount of resources that we can have, and then we can go for the Tyron blocker. And then once they have the maximum resources, I can tax the crap out of them. It doesn't matter, they can still do whatever they want. And, provide for the Empire at home. Sorry about that. Phlegm. So we're getting plus 30 minerals a month from now, which is nice. We're getting there, people. We're starting to make it in a little bit now. This early in the game, I didn't expect to have this much in the way of resources, which is nice. It's very nice indeed. I'm liking it. So this guy's nearly done. Level 4, nearly level 5. As soon as he starts doing some anomalies, he should definitely level up from that. And he'll be max level. Eight more things to survey after this one, I think, or seven more, and then the journey back home. Whee! Here we go, another one. Oh, hey, who's leveled up? That's our scientist, so we expect the third one to level up anytime soon. Lagging behind a little bit. Yep, I thought it'd be you, Ulta. Thought it'd be you. I think because these guys get a nice 5% extra bonus over this guy. Actually, it seems more than that. Oh, because they've got the extra level as well. Because they get the extra 5% over this guy. They level up a little bit faster. And I think he's just caught up. He has. There you go. You now get a nice 11%. You're only 5% behind. It's fine, bro. Don't worry. We'll replace you with somebody better at some point. Let's have a gander, see if we've got anyone. We have. Oh, shit. You see, he is better. I've got no. I'm having you. And let's see, would it actually benefit now? So 20 months, currently got an 11%. Yeah. 1% better, but this guy is only level 1. So, 2 levels behind. Sorry, I know, I feel pretty bad. Don't worry. Don't worry, we're keeping you. You'll still have a place in this glorious empire. I mean, maybe Rigu will suddenly pop
up. Construction complete.
I think what I'm going to do is max out my fleet size, so let's do that. That's 8, 9, 10. Okay, so we can get 12. We'll stick with 10, keep a nice little bit of resources back so we can actually upgrade said ships. Let's make sure I don't press the wrong button. Bam. Yeah, because this screen, the hotkey for this screen is right next to my hotkey for stop and start my recordings. I don't want to accidentally do that, so we're going to equip you with Calguns galore. See if there's anything here I can improve. Oh, excuse me a second. Yeah, sorry. Had to sneeze. Oh dear. So that was only computers. Improved thrusters. Yeah. Improved sensors we haven't got yet, so let's drop you two off. Let's see, how much power do we need? Only 30. I think we can get that from a single medium level 2. Yep, bang on 30. Look at that. There we go, which saves the other slots for armour, because armour does not take any power. Oh dear. So let's save that. Yep. And we'll wait till these two have constructed, and then we'll upgrade all our ships. So we're getting a bit better with our fleet. It's 315 currently, which isn't great, but start a fleet. Excuse me. Oh, hi, construction ship. Where are you off to?
Anomaly found. Construction complete.
We're gonna save it for later. Oh, so we've got all our ships now. We can upgrade the crap out of them. So let's have a look. How much is it gonna cost? 168. Not bad. So we're at 350 right now. Let's see if it boosts up any once that is finished.
Ships upgraded. Construction complete.
405.
System survey complete.
Oh, I just got a message of some sort, which was kind of disturbing. Yep, 405. Nice. Another system survey complete. I think that means our guy is done. He's heading on home. After we've done our serving. Yep, he's heading on home. I think what we'll do, we'll let our construction ship catch up. Save up the resources. So let this guy catch up. Finish his construction projects that he has dotted around. I think we'll later go back and build a mining station here. Wanna come on, there we go. And then return you home. So once he's done his last little bit of construction, which currently now he's going towards building the observatory. And once he's done that, oh dear, blah. We'll start on the anomalies. I want to get this ship cleared because we may need it for an emergency anomaly. They occasionally have ones where you have a time limit to do it, and you never know what ship you're going to need. Usually you need your science ship, sometimes you need your military fleet, occasionally you need your construction ship. It's always nice to have it handy. There he goes, building the observatory, our second one. I think we're going to keep the original planet names as well. I feel mean just kind of, it's like, you know, if someone conquered your home and decided, yes, your town is no longer called Townington. It's now being known as Zerfin Town or something like that. That was a terrible example. Zerfin Town? What the bloody hell's that? I'm rambling because we're just watching a ship build another station. I'm weirdly excited because we get another alien species within our system. We can have a look and actually see if there's any other known species around other than the ones in our empire. It's nice. No, there's just galaxy wide, there's these three, which are the ones we know about. These guys will soon be joining us. Haha. There you go. Anthropoids. I like this list, it's very handy. Shows you all your need to know about you, really. I use this list often when it comes to colonizing new planets to see if I've got anyone compatible for them. I'd rather keep them to their home planets, though. Speaking of which, I'm going to control and save you as number 5. There we go. So it is now, number 5.
Construction complete.
It's my desert people. So we've got an observatory, which is awesome, but now we get to do this. We get to infiltrate them. No, we don't. Why not? Why not? Why not? There's the industrial age for space age. Yeah, they're in the early space age. Right. Oh, it's the policy. Right, we need to change policies, bro. I cannot remember for the life of me how to do that. Planets and sectors, no. Leaders, no. Factions, no. Treaty resources, no. Species, no. Policies and edicts, there we go. Leadership, primary only. We can change this with research, which is very much worth doing. Voting rights? I assume we've got free vote on. Yeah, free vote. Resettlement, not bothered. Migration, not bothered. Native enlightenment, allowed. Native interference, here we go. Passive study, active study. No, we can't do it. We can't get there. Why can we not do this? Does not have the fanatic xenophile. Oh, shocking. Because we chose fanatic xenophiles, we do not want to mess with them. We can, however, maybe. Technological enlightenment. Let's do that. We'll make them a vassal of ours. And get them that way. There's ways and means, people. There's ways and means. Let's have a look at research. It's got a while before anything's finished. The next thing to be finished will be our tile blockers. We can get rid of volcanoes. And then our gravity sensors. So that's kind of upsetting. I'd like to have actually just infiltrated them, but I did not think that being a fanatic xenophile would stop you from doing that. Well, there you go. That's neither here nor there. Let's have a look to starting this anomaly train. We'll do the one in our home sector first. Research the anomaly. 77% risk, which is absolutely minuscule. So we'll just do this anomaly and then go back and we'll wait for the construction ship. Because I doubt this one's going to be anything other than, oh look, extra resources. Hooray. What I could do in the meantime is actually think about building space stations at our other two planets. Maybe.
Construction complete.
I think I might wait a bit for that until we encounter another civilization at least. We haven't come across anything yet. Another space-faring civilization, that is, not our primitives. I like how we're calling them primitives, but the ones I've encountered and are trying to now enlighten into our ways, they're more advanced than we are. 2.5 per month. That is going up nice and fast. They're going to be joining us as a space empire sooner rather than later. And then hopefully once they're a vassal of ours, we can work on integrating them into our empire. Auro Jubak. What a weird name for a planet. Normally it's taking a little longer than I thought it would. I forgot what... I didn't read what this one was. There are signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization on this inhospitable planet at rock. Okay, so that's what we're searching. These signs. Oh, it's a barren world. Okay. We have recovered artifacts from an ancient alien civilization. On Oral Jabok back, whatever. Incredibly, this civilization, which apparently referred to itself as the Cyrex, oh dear, seems to have been made up of machines that were linked together in some sort of collective consciousness. Oh dear. The age of artifacts indicate they were active some 600,000 years ago in this portion of the galaxy, at least, but we have learnt nothing of their exact origins. According to the particle data, I think that is that practical data? Particle data, whatever. According to the particle data fragment that our scientists managed to extract from one of the artifacts, the Cybrex at some point launched a crusade to destroy all sentient organic life in the galaxy for reasons unknown. Things just got a bit Mass Effect-y in here.
Situation log updated.
So we've just got a new ongoing job. Orbital research mandate. I totally forgot I was doing that. We should fulfill that actually very soon. There we go. Okay. So we've got a new thing to study, the Cybex precursor races. So that could be what all these artifacts around, these anomalies are around us. They could be simply artifacts of these precursors, which sound a lot like the Reapers from Mass Effect. idea. What are we doing now? We was waiting for our construction ship to return home. He's currently still building in this sector here.
Construction complete.
How many is that we've built then? We'll keep an eye on our mandate, I think, would be the best idea. 184? We'll build more than that, surely. Oh, we're about to anyway. So that's 5. Is that the only one there? Surely not. Is that two planets we can colonise, like, right next to each other? It is! One of them's the moon for themselves. We haven't built on this one. Oh crap, I selected the wrong thing. That's why. Okay. So we've got another 2 there, that takes us up to 3. Let's have a look for a place we can build a 4th. Just to get the mandate done. Okay, I can't resist. We're building a mining station there. I've got one there. The black hole. Even the black hole doesn't matter. God damn it, really? Oh, I really want to build this. We'll build that later. We'll look for somewhere to build a research station first. I'm sure we'll build a research station there. Yes, we have. Looks like we may have to start looking at these anomalies. No, I think would be the best idea. So let's have a look for another one right here. So let's have a look. Where are you, Mr. Anomaly? Oh, there you are. It's on the moon. That's research risk, another 7% risk. Let's have a look. There are signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization on this inhabitable rock. So another one, very much similar to the last one.
Construction complete.
So while you do that, science team, I'm going to look for your next target. There's a level 2 one there, a level 1 here, a level 1 there, so we may as well go for this one. There you are. So what's this one? Did I miss it? Sorry, one second. Sorry, I think I'm starting with a bit of a cold. I'm sneezing and all phlegmy. The debris field, which TBR-T-668 is part of, rolls and swirls with under the influence of unknown forces. Okay. So we can research risk 22%. Oh, we're getting a bit riskier. After that, we're going to pop over here. It's quite a list of things, isn't it? Making sure they've got the game running and not paused. That's our next one. So that's this one. A small cargo pod has been left to drift in the space above this gas giant. It has been captured by the planet's gravity well and will eventually be pulled into its atmosphere. So we want to stop that from happening. Research risk 7%. There's another one here where we're currently building. Where is it? There you are. So what's this one? Atmospheric readings from ISTA 5 do not match simulated projections. Okay, that is not really that unheard of, but you know, we're not all knowing. That's another one. My god, we've got a lot, haven't we? They assume we are doing that one. I'm going to pause it just so I can get them all done. There you are. What's this one? The blazing fires of Herodus 1 might be throwing our sensors off, but we are picking up readings out of the... we're picking up readings out of the ordinary. It's nice. Is this a molten world? It is a molten world. That would explain about the Stephen Keat. 30... Is that 30? No, it's 10% risk. I don't know why I saw 30. Just pop back out here. Got another anomaly. Right here. Our poor science team are going to be super busy all their bloody lives. Okay, this one. We're receiving a weak signal from the surface of this planet. The source appears to be some kind of tracking beacon. So let's look into that. I'm thinking these tracking beacons are also to do with the Cybrex. We've got, where else? One here. Okay, what's this one? A class 12 asteroid orbits the planet. The small planetoid orbit appears to be too stable for its presence to be natural. Okay, interesting. Let's have a look at that. I'm going to do this one last because that's the most risky one we have. So I think we'll go for this one here first. What's this one? There are signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization on this inhospitable rock. Inhabitable? Oh, whatever. Another Cybrex one, no doubt. And here. Where are we? There you are. So, barren world again. There are signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization on this inhospitable rock. It is inhospitable. I was right. There you go there. And I think that's all I can see for now. So then we'll go to the black hole and have a gander at that one. Where are the black holes? It's the black hole itself, that's comforting. Sensors pick up unusual readings in the vicinity of Riblin Farlux. Readings that are hard to explain being this close to a black hole. 22% risk. And I think that's it. Oh no, it's not. I got another one here, of course. As well as a shed ton of resources to take advantage of. Here we are. What's yours? There are signs of an ancient. Yeah, okay, so another precursor civilization. Let's get that dotted off. And I think that is. Nope. Oh crap. Oh no.
Construction complete.
I don't believe it. I've accidentally not held shift at some point. Oh, it's quite clear. At the black hole, I didn't hold shift. Ah, crap. Okay, I'm going to pause the video and go back through them all again. Damn it. Alright. So, I reset all the anomalies in a slightly different order. I think I got them all. I also noticed these guys just hanging around. But it says they're placid leviathans, so we're all good there. So, yeah, back to the research at hand, and the one we're currently doing is signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization. I also set my construction fleet to, oh here we go, what's this? The ancient frozen remains of almost 1,000 aliens, oh my god. God, have been found in the vicinity of Kion's 4-5A. They come from over a dozen different species, and preliminary data puts the corpses at roughly 600,000 years old. Or in the same time, the Cybrex machines. Our consciousness ravaged the part of the galaxy.
Oh. Situation log updated.
Oh my god. So basically they killed off a load of people and dumped their bodies on that planet. That is nasty as. Organic remains available. So we haven't got a time limit to do this, but oops. I totally forgot what the first anomaly was. Absolutely forgot what that first one was. So let's have a look. Go to. Let's have a look here. Ah, there it is. Okay. So after all said and done, we're gonna have a look at these organic remains. That is gruesome stuff. So, what's the anomaly we're going to have a gander at now? It's another precursor, I think. It's level 1. I think all the precursors are the level 1s. Yeah, there are signs of activity for... So with Cybrex, they are dark. So a machine consciousness that wiped out life in the galaxy by the looks of it and dumped them all on that moon. That is pretty revolting. I'm hoping that's not what we keep coming across.
Research complete.
Nice. What do we research? Oh, the Tyler blocker. So let's have a look. Border range 20%, might get that. Mox building of biolabs. I'm going to go for border range. Let's actually have a look. 1 month until we get the gravity sensors. That's nice. Oh, so this is already over an hour video. I was intending to do about half an hour videos from now on.
Research complete.
But this one's just got interesting, so I don't want to bail out now. A colossal space battle occurred in high orbit above Skeptrum 4A. Some 600,000 years ago, with ships from at least 5 different fleets participating. One of the fleets belonging to the Cybrex. Although the vast majority of orbital debris seems to come from other participants. So a battle occurred around this area, around that space, and it seems the Cybrex
situation log updated.
Destroyed much more than they lost. Which gives the impression that they were hyper-advanced. Along with the fact that they're a highly developed AI race, it's not looking good. Research people 5%. Hell yeah, yeah. Grab that while we can. Let's have a look. Where are we off to now? I do believe it's another. Yep, another one. These Cybrexes. They are looking pretty threatening. So we're at 55% with our Enlightenment attempt, which is fantastic. We're getting 2.5% each month, so it shouldn't be too long until they are a space empire like ourselves. Keep calling it empires is more of a republic, isn't it? A democratic thing.
Construction complete.
Oh, crap, I've just wondered. 1 second. This planet that contains 11, is it in close proximity to these guys? Let's have a look. These guys are here. Yeah, I may lose these when these guys get enlightened. Oh dear. Playing the long game. We'll get it back. didn't think that through fully, did I? We'll have a bit of time where we get to take advantage of it beforehand. So this guy's now fully 5-star. He's leveled up as much as he will. So, okay, the hostile and unforgiving world of Cybrex 2B was home to what once appears to have been a large Cybrex base. Oh god. Nothing remains of it now, aside from scattered debris and a large crater. We'll have to investigate the site of the base more closely if we want to learn more.
Situation log updated.
We get another research project to do here. As our science ship flutters on to the next destination. Again, I didn't do these in the same order I did last time, so they're not all going to be these Cybrex anomalies that we've discovered. In fact, most of them are not. Because I just kind of went in whatever was closest to me at the time. So we have these three projects, four projects. Oh, we have to completely do them in order to get these. Okay, I see. So we're now going to the awesome black hole. I love these black holes do look cool, don't they? I've never seen a picture of the black hole, to be honest. Oh, obviously I've never seen a black hole, but I've never seen what they look like, so I don't know if this is accurate or not. I know they wouldn't say it like that, because sound does not travel in space. I can't zoom out because that's very loud actually. Come on, man. Are you nearly done? Sweet. Failure? What? Science Officer Bigger has issued a report indicating that they are none too pleased of having been ordered to study. Oh, fuck yourself. That was a failure. That's a problem. Well, we got... Oh, hang up. I suppose we got lucky that we got a research station, that it didn't destroy our ship. Oh, and crap, we're not going to build the research station in time because we've got a election coming up. That's a shame. Oh well, can't be helped. We tried, we nearly got there. Got one more. Occupied with these anomalies. I love that flanger effect they've got going on there. Right, okay. Wow, you took the longest route to here. Okay. Looking on this planet here, what's this? Class 12 asteroid. Oh yeah, that's the asteroid that's in orbit. That shouldn't, by natural laws, be in orbit. Do you reckon it could be the Cybrex again? Using the asteroid as a base to house a death ray or something like that. Enough to get rid of your xenophobia trait. Xenophile trait. Oh, here we go. What's this? Ilse has been elected as revered elder of the Etheri Covenant. Consult the situation log to see the mandate. Our revered elder's reign has come to an end, with their election campaign promise unfulfilled. Oh, well, that's a shitter, isn't it? Let's see, did you used to have a position? We have elected our current ruler, Ilthi. Ilthi. So you must have a mandate, my good friend, which is what? Research stations, of course it is. Can it not be mineral stations? We're building a crap ton of them. So we've got a lot of resources now. I'm starting to think it might be worth building an army. We've got enough resources to buy them all. As I said, we don't really need them. Discovered about this asteroid in close orbit. Close orbit of Akmal. Akmal 6.
Construction complete.
Tight. Okay. For some reason, someone's towed an asteroid into stable orbit around Akmal 6. The massive engines massive engine sections and braking thrusters can still be found on the surface, although they have long since been rendered inoperable. Okay. So, you know what that means? Research station, right here, bro. There's one of our mandates fulfilled. We promised research, we shall deliver. Not like our last elder, that lazy son of a bitch. Actually, a look at his traits. Here we go. Inventor, energy credits plus 10%, that's alright. Space miner, nice, nah, I like that. Okay, so let's have a look. Is it another precursor? Please, no. It's not, I don't think. Atmospheric readings from. The readings don't match our previous indications. That's cool, that's fine, we can deal with that. We are running out of energy credits, actually. We're going to need to back that up at some point soon.
Research complete.
Okay. Enlightenment complete. Okay. The thousands of scientists and advisors we sent to Avlik Zajax have finally completed the audacious task of bringing the local civilization up to an early space age level of technology. Under their new united government, the aliens now style themselves as the Evandi Union, Evandari Union, and they have agreed to become our vassals. Swish! Our observation post above the homeworld has been dismantled as per conditions of our treaty with them. This is a great day. So we have our very first vassal, which is awesome. So we've got these guys. Oh, that's sorry. Swirling shadows. Immense ragged planes of shadow drift across Istar-5's face. They are cast not by clouds, but by sheets of organic materials drifting through the upper layers of the atmosphere. Hinged, or rather joined, to allow for a small degree of articulation. Science Officer Rigu, I still like that name, Rigu, is as yet unwilling to say whether these things are flora or fauna, or what possible purpose, if any, the elaborate shadow casting might serve. Okay, let's just have a gander at this. It's no research project, but there is a station to be built.
Construction complete.
So we're off to our next destination. Bam, we've arrived at our next destination. So let's see here, what's this one? The blazing fires. Okay. Oh, yeah, I forgot research was complete and somebody leveled up. Which research? You research. Okay, engineering. Oh, covert assembly yards. Yes, please. This is where we start getting progressing towards bigger, better ships. Hooray, hooray, hurrah. So that's what we're going to put a little bit of focus into now. Now we've got a vassal to protect, you know. So let's see what the readings come out on this planet. See if it is the molten lava throwing off our sensors, or whether our readings are generally misled. Looks like we're lacking on engineering departments in our empire. What's that? I think while we wait, what was we up to? You. We're gonna need to build a power plant. Right there. You are gonna need to build a mining network when you come round to it. Right there. Engineering research. Bam. Build a basic science lab. And you can't really do anything because I've not got the upgrade for you. Okay. So we'll let our planet keep ticking over. We have found an old mining station around the planet's Hideous One, drifting in orbit. It was surely used to mine the planet of its resources, obviously, but by whom remains a mystery. Yeah, that is very true. The technology within the station is very close to our own. We should be able to take hold of the station and have it up and running in no time. Or we could always scrap it for parts. Take control of the station. As adaptive mining facility modifier. Has that done it for us? Has that added the... I assume so. There's no research project. Yeah, no. Okay, next project. 7 more tasks for this ship to do. Speaking of which, let's actually have a look at this planet is going to need attention very soon. They are out of extra food, so I think that's our next goal. Sort that planet out. In fact, do they have 5 pops? They have 7. They have 5.
Construction complete.
Oh, we can well upgrade them. In fact, we need to. Another thing I'm going to actually just double check is these are our subservients. Our vassals. Are we allowed to integrate them? I know we won't be able to yet. We have the option. Yes. Protectorate subjects cannot be integrated. Damn it. Has to have been a subject for 3,600 days. Are they a protectorate or are they a vassal? I'd assume they was a vassal. Oh god damn it, protectorate. Why do they not like me? Minus 12. Are you kidding? I could always just, you know, kind of invade you. But that would be improper. That just would not be cricket. Ooh, speaking of which, let's have a look. What's the anomaly this time? We're receiving a weak signal from the surface of this planet. The source appears to be some kind of tracking beacon. What I'm going to actually do is... I think that's 8. Let's have a look. Yep, there we go. So that should be a full fleet of ships. Oh, my bad. Full fleet of ships, and we don't have to worry about that for a while now. Apparently that didn't actually cost us all that much. So our main fleet is going to get a nice chunk of reinforcements. A small short-range transmitter has been located on the surface of asteroid 4. It appears to be an ancient survey marker that's placed here eons ago to mark a large deposit of precious metals that mines it was meant to eventually... What? The mines it was eventually... It was meant to evidently never arrived. Oh, the miners... God. The miners... The miners it was meant to evidently never arrived. Oh, the miners it was meant for, my god. As the deposit is still here. Okay. Sorry, wow. Just brain fart there. Oh, we can't build it. Oh, shocking. Because it's not in our space. Brr. I think we're second to last one here. And that'll be all the anomalies done, I think. Okay, of course it's across the other side of the bloody system. The debris field, which is part of a swirl. Yeah, okay. So the debris field that
construction complete.
Swirls with an unknown energy. Twirls and swirls. So we've got most of our energy resources back, and I think that is pretty much because our protectorate has taken them from us, which is unfortunate. I'm good, I can't integrate them. That plan just didn't work out for me as well as I was hoping. Can I offer them vassalization? Let's have a look here. What can we do for you? I don't like that they don't like us. Xenophile diplomacy plus 20. Wise spirituals plus 10. Relative power to subject minus 72. Jesus. Trust plus 11. Subject plus 25. They should get a nice boost of trust, however. They are loyal, which is nice. Their strength is pathetic. They have 5 ops. Offer trade deal, no. Release subject, yeah, insult, declare war, offer migration treaty, close borders, integrate subject. I really want to do this, but I don't think I can. I can't do that. I can offer them a trade deal, but they won't have anything to trade. So let's just quickly have a gander at what space they took from me. Oh! Dimensional pocket. That seems pretty cool. Let's just have a zoom in there. The SOTR, our room, never made it all the way to TBR-T-668 to study the to study the anomalies surrounding it. The ship, along with science officer Rigu and crew, blinked out of existence as it was navigating the debris field, and then reappeared minutes later. Oh, I forgot. Rigu reports that they found themselves briefly in some extra dimensional space. Okay. External viewpoints revealed that they were surrounded by countless ships of alien design, suspended in a seemingly endless void before the crew could get their bearings. The vision abruptly faded, and they found themselves back in regular space. However, roughly half the crew are missing. Damn. Science officer Rigu speculates that they may have been selectively trapped by some unknown mechanism in the strange space. Oh, that is weird. Unfortunate. That's your reaction. It's just unfortunate that. Okay, so we didn't really gain anything from that. Yeah. Never mind. Next destination. process. Oh! The missing members of SOTR Arum's crew fought loss to the dimensional rift have reappeared. Nice. They hailed us from aboard an unknown vessel, not entirely dissimilar to our own science ships. I deem close to where the SOTR Alvrum originally experienced the dismantlement disturbance. That's they claim to remember nothing of the time outside of their dimension, aside from a vague awareness of having been away for some time. They wish nothing but to return to the service under Science Officer Rigu, and intend to surrender their ship to the Etherian authorities. The safety of Etherian people hinges on the destruction. Oh god, no, very well. So it looks like we have a new science ship. Called Other Science Ship. Holy crap, what the hell is that? Let's put that up here. It looks like it's on fire. That is cool, but weird at the same time. I don't know which I prefer, mine or this one. It makes a very loud noise though, doesn't it? Anyway, back to anomalies. Let's see here. A small cargo pod this time. So, hypnotized by it, it's cool looking but weird. And very noisy. Very noisy indeed. So while that's doing that, I'm gonna have a look at these guys. Have they taken my high yield station away from me? Yeah, they have. Boo! Boo! Boo, that was mine, you bastards. Boo. Ah, well. We can tolerate that, I suppose. How many ships have they got? Like one? Or, yep, one. Bless them. They have a science ship. They have a construction ship. Nice. I want to see them progress. Okay. The discarded cargo pod was left by someone in the upper atmosphere of Eaton Stellar 5 long ago. This somehow escaped the notice of other spacefarers, and its decaying orbit means it would have been lost to the gas giant's crushing atmosphere within another few years. When the crew of the SOTR Alrum unsealed the pod, they found a stash of alien jewelry made out of precious metals. Swish. So we just gained a load of energy credits for that, which can't snuff it out, I suppose. Not what I would have preferred. I would have preferred a nice constant boost to our minerals or something like that. But then again, from a little alien pod, you wouldn't get that, would you?
Construction complete.
I don't know where you're off to, mate. Are you jumping again? I think you're jumping again. Whee! Ah, right, you're returning home by the looks of it. So, yeah, he's going to go off to do all those other research projects now, which is fan-dizzy-dozy. So, in the meantime, we're going to have a look at this, and one of us is struggling for food. Who is it? Who is... got less food, you guys. No, first of all, we're going to change governor. We're going to put this guy in charge. He will arrive there shortly.
Research complete.
Ah, stop it. And we're going to pause things because I'm going to end it here in a moment. I'm just going to set up basic combat roles. Deflectors could be very useful. Unlocks module observatory. What's that? Maintenance. Planet modifier, planet sensor range plus 50%. Not really that bothered. We'll go for combat roles. There we go. 8 months. Okay, what was I doing now? Who did I give the leader to? Was it you guys? It was you guys. Let's go have a look at this planet. I'm going to set up a load of building here. Primarily farms. Although, this could do with upgrading. Well, I didn't press nothing. What are you doing? Okay, that's fine. It's actually doing what I want it to do. Actually, you know what? No. I think I'll do that left. Let's cancel that for now. Yup. Let's do these first. Build farm. Build a temple unity. Nope. Basic. A power plant. Right, you build a power plant also. No one there. Build a power plant. You build a science lab. You there. Be cleared of your volcanic mountains. You too. Clear those volcanic mountains. Who else? You there. Build me a basic power plant. You upgrade to that. And last but not least, building a spaceport. Okay guys, so that's where I'm going to leave it off. A lot has happened. How much minerals have we got left? We've got a bit left. I think 19. Let's have a look actually. Can we get 20, 21, 22? There we go. Oh, timing because my phone's ringing. So join me again next time. See you then.